Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my vids and more. Link in the description below. All right, welcome back, YouTubers and Madden fans. This is Madden Money Shot, bringing you another Madden 18 update. If you guys haven't noticed, I've been doing too many Money Play videos lately. The last one I put out maybe a week ago didn't really do that great. So I'm guessing you guys are kind of past that, to the point of looking forward to Madden 18 just like I am. So I'm trying to give you as many Madden 18 updates and my take on some of the information coming out as possible, because I'm jacked up for this game. I put out my last gameplay as well. It went pretty bad. I'm not going to play another game. I'm just going to basically refresh for Madden 18, which is, I'm pretty sure, what you guys are doing too. So I'm going to bring you as much updates as I can as possible. Hit the like button for me if you would. That definitely helps me out. If you want to see more stuff like this, it lets me know that you're interested. So this one right here, this is basically the Madden mechanics. This is basically all geared towards gameplay. This is really all that I care about. There's a lot of updates coming out about a lot of stuff I don't care about. The clothes they're wearing, the music that there's going to be in the game, I don't care about none of that. Tattoos on the players, who cares? But the gameplay is important. That's really, if you can put all that other stuff aside, all I really care about is you fixing the game. So I saw this, it was posted about a week ago, but like I said, I never saw it a week ago. So I'm going to give you guys my take on it anyway. I'm going to kind of read in between the lines of what they're saying and what they actually mean, because a lot of times they tell you something kind of backwards, hoping you don't figure out what they really mean. So there's some really good stuff in here that gets me really jacked up for the next game, and there's some stuff that I can tell right away is kind of troubling, and I'm going to give you my take on both of that. If you guys disagree with what I have to say, leave in the comment section, or hit the dislike button, which I'm sure you guys will. The last video I put out complained about some of the new directions they were going in Mutt, and I had people complain, and my response to that is, don't be sheep, man. They're playing you. Okay, they have a reason to try to con you when it comes to Mutt, because they're making money off of Mutt. They have no reason to con you when it comes to gameplay. So, you know, this here I think is going to be a much more honest attempt to get it right. So let's go ahead and let's move down real quick. First thing I noticed is you see a rookie out of LSU, is Jamal Adams. He's got his picture right there, so I'll let you know this is definitely a new picture from new gameplay, I would imagine. There's some stuff that everybody already knows about, the new passing mechanics, the target passing, stuff like that. I don't think it's going to be as big as people think. I think it will be big when you come down to the goal line. I think people are going to work that fade route, bring that back into the Madden community, which is kind of worthwhile because people had so much trouble scoring on goal line. Basically, my take on reading the off-ball injuries, it's only in simulation mode, which is good. I don't really want that in competitive mode. Nobody in competitive mode wants to lose their best players. That's annoying. When you go into a game and your quarterback gets hurt in the first quarter, you got nobody really to throw in after him. So that's not something that the competitive community wants. But apparently the simulation community, which I've had an issue with in the past, where I really don't understand to begin with, wants that. And I can understand that to an extent. It makes the game more realistic. But who really likes it when, you know, you score on a big 40-yard touchdown play and all of a sudden you're missing your quarterback or something like that because he got hit after the ball, or your offensive lineman's out for the season for some random reason? I don't like randomness. I think that's really stupid. I don't like, you know, they did that for a while with penalties, where you just every once in a while you'd randomly get a holding penalty. You'd be like, what the hell did I do wrong to deserve a holding penalty? Yeah, it makes the game a little bit more realistic, but it also puts up unrealistic roadblocks that you didn't earn. You know what I'm saying? I'm a competitive player. If I make a mistake, I own it. You know what I'm saying? I don't mind. If I earn my mistakes, I earn my mistakes. The same way if I earn my rewards, I earn my rewards. But when it comes to stuff like random penalties and off-ball injuries, I'm not a fan of that, which is fine because I don't really play simulation anyway. If I join a league this year, though, I'm hoping that they have the sense to put it on competitive mode, because I think that'll be an option. But if you guys out there that wanted it, hey, now your lineman could be out for the season just randomly, because apparently that's what people want. You can just randomly lose your best players. Yay for the Madden community. Like I said, that's part of a community I don't really consider myself. I'm not really part of the sim community. I'm a competitive player. So I guess that's what you wanted. You got it. Now here's something more towards the gameplay that I do like. They basically made it a little bit harder for you to get user picks in a way. I'm not going to say that that's really the design. But basically, there's people out there that hold triangle throughout the whole play. That's not something I typically ever did. I typically would time it. I didn't even know it gave you an advantage if you really want to know the truth about it. But I guess they're taking away the ability to hold the triangle throughout the entire play. It will actually make it harder for you to get interceptions by doing that. You have to time it better, which is typically what I do anyway. So, hey, I'm all happy for that. No problems there. But basically, you know, you better start timing these picks instead of just holding the triangle button, which I didn't even know that worked. So, something I didn't really notice. Here's another one I really like, the hit stick mechanic. They changed this back to what it was, which is basically just do it with the right thumb, with the right thumbstick, which is the only way I ever did it anyway. I'm old school. I always did it that way. That's how it first came out. That's how I always did it. But apparently, I guess you could do it with other buttons, and I didn't even really realize that. I guess there's I know there's a couple different ways to hit stick, but I never really bothered to learn any of them. I just used the good old-fashioned one. So now to be able to get hit stick fumbles, it's really based off of timing, which always kind of was, and what angle you're facing your opponent. You can also have the ability to make it a high hit stick or a low hit stick. I'm going to have to figure out what really causes more fumbles. I'm probably going to research that pretty good. Low hit sticking or high hit sticking. I would imagine low hit sticking is a more safe tackle, where high hit sticking might get more fumbles, but I'm not really sure. So I'm going to have to figure that out. And when I figure out what makes the most fumbles happen, I'm going to be sure to pass it on to you guys in a tip video. They got a thing here where they're addressing ball carrier special moves. I heard that they're kind of back to what they were in 16, where the shaker, what do they call that? The juke move is much more effective, like it was. I thought the juke move was plenty effective in this last year. They're saying that you will be able to shake and bake AI control players just as well as actual players, user defender players. So those moves might be dirty this year. We're gonna see. I mean, I thought that the juke move was great. Spin move stank. Spin move was a lot better a couple years back. Stiff arm was really good. I mean, I thought that they were fine last year, but it makes it sound like they might have improved them. Now, here's something that I'm totally jacked for. My last gameplay video I put out, I must have dropped like 15 picks. Not me personally as much as my teammates, my computer teammates, as well as me switching over at the last second and trying to pick it off. They were just not catching anything. Well, apparently the dropped interceptions thing is going to be down this year. It says one of the top competitive complaints to me says the defenders are dropping wide open interceptions. Happens all the time. A lot of times they don't even go for the pick, they just swat the ball. It says they're not gonna do that anymore. It says that now AI defenders will go for the ball every time, and they'll have a higher chance of catching the ball based on the fact that that's I've heard this once, I've heard this 1,000 times. They're saying do not make bad reasons, gang, you'll be throwing picks all day, and they're just reinforcing that with this. They do, however, have to have a certain amount of a certain catching rating, which if you play Ultimate Team like I do, there's guys like Champ Bailey who's got like 80 catch and stuff like that. So these guys are going to be getting picks all day. So make sure that you check and make sure that your guy's got good hands, and he will not be dropping picks. He'll be getting picks all day. So here's something that they took out that a lot of people can be happy about: the swerve. The swerve looks like it's going to be dead. We'll see how good players are when they're not cheesing that to death. I didn't use that the entire year. I don't really waste my time figuring out how to do these things that are going to be fixed. So I didn't waste my time with the swerve, so it's not going to be an issue for me. But either way, now your defenders will be playing the ball, the spot of the ball, rather than the receiver. So it should solve that. It should also make them better defenders if you really want to choose better, if they're playing the ball, because that's how you really should be playing defense. You shouldn't be playing the receiver. I guess they were getting some complaints about the curl flat zones. I never really had an issue with them. I just basically knew that curl flats would play two routes to one side, they would tape. This is the light purple zone, if you guys don't know, the curl flat zone. If there was two receivers on one side, it would typically, if it had to choose, would choose the shorter receiver, the closer receiver to the line of scrimmage. So I guess now they did something, because people were complaining about that, where there's something called a no cover zone, which means that underneath defenders, they won't cover. If there's a receiver under 5 yards, they won't cover that. They'll stay back, which is cool. That's a good improvement. I can't say I have a problem with that, but it could be troublesome. All it really is, though, you just have to know what these zones do. A lot of people don't actually know what the zones do, so they're upset when they get beat by something. But since I know what these zones do, it's not really an issue. You just have to know how to operate within the limits. Now, jumping ahead here in this article to the hard flat zones, another one that they had an issue with, it says that they weren't aggressive enough in playing the flats. I think that's specifically geared towards mesh double drats, which is, they need something. I hear that they took away the ability to cross man. They're not going to let you cross man defenders this year. So the hard flats need to work. They need to stick those double drags, because that's really going to be the only thing left to stop it. And this way, they're basically just playing it way more aggressive, which I think is a good thing. Now, going back to hit sticking, fumble recoveries. How many times if a ball come out from your quarterback gets sacked, it's on the ground, nobody's around, nobody even seems to notice, especially your offensive lineman. Your offensive lineman never disengaged the block, and you're just basically screwed waiting for the first computer defender to run by and pick it up. Well, I guess they made people more aware when the ball's on the ground, including better animations to pick the ball up. Who really cares? Grab the ball and close. But really what I want is, when the ball's on the ground, get my lineman to go crazy and go get the ball. It should be a fair fight for the ball, where it really wasn't this year. So fumbles from, quarterbacks and stuff, people are going to be diving at it like crazy. Now, as far as user-controlled middle linebackers, I guess they tried to make it as realistic as possible, where you have to have a pretty good linebacker to control the center of the field. I don't know how they're really going to make that possible. I've been using lowly rated middle linebackers forever, as long as they're fast, hopefully have a decent hit power, maybe good, you know, height, strength, whatever. As long as they have good physical measurables, you can use a crappy inside linebacker. But I guess they're trying to make it so that you can't. Now they're trying to make it so that you're going to want to get a good middle linebacker, or they're not going to play as good. So we'll see what happens there. If you're still a really good player, I don't think that's going to stop you. Here's an issue I never had any issues with at all: rack drops. I heard people complain about it, where you would catch the ball or you try to catch the ball in a rack and it would just hit the turf. I don't think I've ever had that issue where my rack catches didn't happen. But basically, you know, I guess they're trying to improve rack catching so that doesn't happen as much. Now, the one thing that I do have an issue with is they're changing the tuning on the organic knockout system. The organic knockout system is one of the best ways to play defense in this game, which is basically accumulative hits from your defenders would eventually make the ball come out. So if two guys were on a guy and they were all over him, the ball would come out. Or, you know, if one guy's on him and another guy came and finished him off, the ball would come out. That's one of the best ways to defend receivers. Where now, I guess they kind of changed that so that dropping the ball after a collision, they're going to hold on to the ball more. So now I think you're going to see people mossing a lot more. This is something I actually don't like too much if they tweak this a little bit too much. Where you're going to see people going up mossing people with every receiver now, because it sounds like they're going to try to make sure the ball sticks to the receiver, which is fine, but when you have like 6'5 receivers and stuff like that going up and snatching it in traffic, I can't say I'm a fan of that. That's not realistic. So we'll see. That could be an issue that a lot of people complain about, if they basically put that in a way that people are going to have an issue with it, where they're just basically mossing everybody again like they did a couple years ago. Here's something interesting: direct control of rack catches. Basically, they're saying if you're too close to the sideline, if you hit the left stick in the up position when you catch the ball, that you'll immediately turn upfield instead of running out of bounds. That I like, because there's a lot of times where you just don't have space and there's nobody around you and you left all this room on the field. You could have had like a 40-yard touchdown, but because you're too close to the sideline, you ran out of bounds. So that's something you're going to want to work on. Here's something I don't necessarily agree with too much. They have size and weight factor. They're basically going to say that when it comes to hit sticking and causing fumbles, that the size of your player and the weight of them is going to be one of the biggest determining factors. That's fine. You know what I'm saying? That's important. If you have a much bigger guy hitting a much smaller guy, it makes sense. But what about guys like Bob Sanders, who's only 5'8", but are known for just laying people out? I mean, there's a lot of defenders on the smaller side that are just known for laying people out, and I hope that doesn't affect that too much. So to me, they're trying to be more realistic, but there's a lot of small guys out there that really lay the wood. It seems like they did something for accuracy to lower rated quarterbacks. I could have swore I heard them say that they did that last year, and the year before that, and the year before that, and the year before that, that lower rated quarterbacks with bad accuracies would not be as accurate as regular quarterbacks. So this sounds like lip service to me. But hey, who knows? We'll see. I mean, there are some high-rated quarterbacks that have horrible accuracy for reasons we don't understand. We all know that guy. There's always guys that have low-rated accuracies that, for whatever reason, work great for us, and the guys that have high-rated accuracies that just can't hit, you know, water if it fell out of a boat. So we'll see how that works. This is something good for all you guys like the lab out there. Defense and practice mode will now have some sort of AI thing, so that while you're trying to lab exotic blitzes or basically nanos and glitches, they will actually wait till you're done putting in your audibles to run the play. So that's pretty cool. Says that they're working on they're trying to change something as far as slower players catching faster players in open field, which happens a lot. Somebody's busting a 60-yard touchdown and a defensive lineman catches a running back. So they're gonna tell you that doesn't work anymore. We'll see. So that's it. Hopefully I gave you guys some stuff to get excited about, some stuff that you didn't know. And that's it. Thanks for watching. Madden Moy, shit out.